Hey YouTubers, it's Aaron. We're here with the Tippmann A5. We discussed in our last video that we're gonna do multitude of upgrades. So that actually has finally come. We have here the Palmer's Pursuits male stabilizer, regulator. So we're gonna do a little quick video on how to install that. It also came with like a little seal kit, so O-rings and stuff like that, little spares. So let's get right to it. The reason why I decided to do this video is there ain't any videos on how to set this up properly, and I noticed that the only reason, or the only way I found out on how to use it, was through forums and stuff like that. So instead of having people go through 1,000 forums to read up on something so small, and really all I needed to know was in one sentence, and it was like literally like eight paragraphs of stuff. So I just had to read through everything really good. And so yeah, in the box, okay, we'll just set the gun aside. So when you get it, I've already opened this, so I've already went ahead, took the liberty of putting Teflon tape and stuff like that, put that on all the fittings. So this is the Palmer's Pursuit sticker that it comes with. Pretty cool. The reg and the hose. And another fitting. Okay. So like I said, I've already went ahead, opened the box, and put Teflon tape on each of the fittings before we go ahead and do this. Figured it'd save a little bit of time. Okay. And in the bubble wrap here, you got the reg. Okay, so I also went ahead and put a gauge on mine. Seeing as it didn't come with a gauge, I just had one sitting around. So if you want a gauge, I think they're like anywhere between 10 to 15 bucks. You can just go on eBay and pick up a 0 to 1500 PSI gauge, and they will fit this one just perfectly. It's nice to know what the pressure is, because otherwise, not knowing what the pressure is, I guess you could eliminate a lot of headache that way, knowing about it. So let's get right into it. So first, what you want to do, let's get this elastic off here. All right. Pick an end, I guess. Or actually, no, we'll do this separately, and I'll show you why. A little bit of a pain in the ass. So we'll just take this end, and we'll just go ahead and we'll screw it into the fitting here. All right. There we go. So, yeah, you just screw it in. And taking an adjustable. And just tighten it up. Just tighten it. You don't need it to be Superman tight. All right. When I put the gauge on, it makes it a little bit easier for me to hold the reg when I put this on. So I kind of thought about that. So other than that, this install is not too hard. Okay, so here we go. Snug. Okay, so that's step one. So we'll just set this aside for a minute. Clean this all up. I'm gonna take the barrel off the gun, so we don't need the barrel right now. Makes it easier to work with here. So the barrel off the side. So when you get to this point, what you're gonna want to do is you're gonna want to push out all your push pins. And we'll also push out the one for the tombstone as well.
Like I always was.
This one's kind of tough to get out, but there you go. So your tombstone and your trigger frame, that's what you want to remove. And we'll set that aside. Okay. We're gonna need the tombstone, so we're gonna unscrew that. Okay, so this is what your reg is going to screw into. All right, so this will actually go directly into the tombstone. So, let's go ahead and do that. Let's put that on. There we go. Set that aside. Now, for your grip frame, seeing as this is a semi-automatic trigger frame, we're gonna have to also remove not only this line, but we're gonna have to remove this fitting at the end here, as this one here is just a tad different. So we're gonna also take this ASA off, and we're gonna put that into a vise, or you can get another set of adjustable vice grips, or not vice grips, I would recommend vice grips. Just another adjustable wrench would be fine. So we're gonna unscrew that. And the reason why I'm doing this is you will see why. It is very tough to get that out. You do not want to attempt to remove this fitting while your ASA is still connected to your plastic grip frame, okay? So if you catch my drift, you gotta be very careful with this stuff. So you just bring it down to your ASA and the fitting. So let's go ahead and put this in. Let's just grab another set of make it easier on ourselves here. So we'll just set that there like so, and we'll hold it in with our thumb and index finger. All right, and you just want to, it's very very stiff, so you want to just reef this off the best you can. There we go, it's actually turning. I didn't think it was gonna. So these are Loctited from the factory. So there we go, we can just undo that. Take your whole line, set that aside. You will not be needing that anymore. So now we can just take our other fitting that came with this and put it right back in that exact same spot. Right. Once again, you could do this in a vise, which is probably recommended, but this here is just an easier way of doing it for me personally. So we'll just tighten that up real good. The use of Teflon tape and maybe thread lock is recommended. All right, there we go. So now that we got the new fitting onto the ASA, we could probably now put that back onto the grip frame. But I'm gonna spin this around one more time. Snug, because when we air it up, we're just gonna make sure it doesn't leak. I'm pretty sure it's not gonna leak. I think it'll be okay. All right, so we'll take this, slide this right back into our grip frame, and replace the screw. All right. There we go. So now we can continue to screw into our new line into the ASA. All right. There we go. Just start screwing that in there. Grab your little adjustable wrench here. And we can just start tightening that up. Like I said, you don't want it too tight. Just snug is fine. This is a little awkward putting it on here. And I got a little bit too much play in this adjustable. So other than that, this is pretty much the most amount of bullshit you're going to be putting up with this. So there we go. So now that it is screwed in, we can now go ahead and install this back onto the gun. Alright, we'll just take our tombstone, like I said, slide it in normally, slide on our grip frame, and there you go, she is installed. Simple as that. So there we go, we got the Palmer's stabilizer kit installed into the A5. Took no more than about 20-30 minutes, so a very, very quick install. The regulator comes set about 500 psi out of the box, so we're going to want to turn that up to about 800, which is the operating pressure of the gun. And that's where we get to have a little bit of fun experimenting with how low we could drop our pressures. I was reading on a forum, I know you could drop them as low as 650-700 and still fire. So we'll check that out, but we're gonna start setting it at 800 as per usual with the operating pressure, which is logical. Anything else, any lower, which is a bonus, we'll be able to drop and lower our pressures and save air. If we could do that, that'd be quite awesome. And with the zero kick hammer that we're gonna be also installing in this gun later on down the road, it's gonna really allow us to drop our pressures of the gun and operate at a lower pressure. I'm guessing anywhere between 750-800 would be probably where we're going to end up being. I don't have any air right now on me at the moment, so I cannot air this up and show you how to turn it all the way up to 800 psi. Like I said, 500 out of the box, 800, 750-800 is where we're going to want to hover around in order for this gun to cycle properly. Other than that, that is pretty much the install of the Palmer's Pursuit male stabilizer for the Tippmann A5. So if you have any questions, comments, feel free to comment in the section below. Also stay tuned. We're going to be doing a few more videos on the A5 and getting that all situated here. And looking forward to seeing this gun shoot really, really, really consistently over the chronograph, because that's pretty much the goal that we're going for here, and is the reason, the main reason why we're installing the Pursuit kit. But yeah, other than that, happy Remembrance Day if you are in Canada, and yeah, cheers, see you next time.